Hi, this is Wayne, better known as the Average Gamer. What I'm going to do right now is welcome you to my series on how'd he do that using PowerDirector 10. And first of all, let's go ahead and select our clip. I have a pre-selected clip here. I have some clips segmented, and as you can see, I have them already segmented, and I'm pulling out the nomenclature for the video track, audio track, and those are the things you see on the right hand side. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to break down the video that I did preceding this, and all we're going to go over today is transitions. This is the basic thing that you should learn right off the bat, is how to use transitions and use the transitions well. Every video looks good when you start to use different transitions. It makes it a smooth process to make mini montages or just mini video clips or something you just want to accentuate in your video. So what you may not know in PowerDirector 10 is you can right click and you can modify the transition behavior, and what you have is an overlay and you have cross. And what I like to do is I like to test out both the overlay and the cross as I preview the clip that I'm doing. And what I do is I pick out the one that best fits my needs. There are some other things that we can do with our actual transition, and I could actually shrink the transition to crossfade slower, or I could expand it to make the crossfade go longer. I'm not going to do that today. I may do that on another day, but right now the default length that they make the clips for the transitions is good enough for what we're going to do today. And so right now I'm just taking my clip, I'm just manually moving it, and I'm moving on to my next transition. Now you may say, Tag, well, how do you know which transitions you want to pick? I don't know what transitions I want to pick. I kind of look at the video and I see which way the action is going, and I try to pick something that goes smoothly along with that action. I may not always pick out the right clip, but sometimes, you know, sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. But you got to play around with it, and you see what works and you see what doesn't work. And of course, you the YouTubers out there, you will tell me whether or not you like it or not. So you may say good job, or you may say, man, those that transition you used, that was pretty crappy, or it wasn't very smooth. Those are the ones I do. I've only received information like that from probably one person, and you know, I went to look at his videos, and of course, my goodness, I think it was just a ploy for me to look at his videos, but what he did wasn't very good. It wasn't HD quality, and you know, if you're going to do things in a professional manner, you got to try to do it the best of your ability and get it to the best quality. If you're on YouTube, I'm sorry, you know, you can capture with your phone to get started. Excuse me. You can capture with other things. But HD PVR or the Elgato, you know, any type of HD capturing will basically get you what you need to do. Okay, and as you can see, I'm just going through all the transitions. I mean, PowerDirector 10 has so many different type of transitions. And if you don't have PowerDirector 10, let's say you have PowerDirector 8 or 9 or 11, most of the things that you see here are going to look exactly the same. And I'm pretty sure it works the same way for Sony Vegas. If you have one version, then of course it probably translates over to the next version. You know what I mean? They don't really change. And so what I'm doing now, again, of course, I'm testing my transitions. You always want to look at and review your work. Don't just plow ahead trying to rush through a video. You can't rush something that you actually care about or that you're actually passionate about. I mean, I know a lot of you guys, you upload videos super fast and you throw a commentary over top of it. Well, I challenge you to take your time and actually not only perfect your commentary, you've already perfected your game because you have an exciting and really good gameplay. But now, let's add something a little bit different. Add some editing to your videos. That's the key to rising to the top. And right now what I have is I have a prefab template. This is, of course, a PNG image that I already have set up. And what I want to do is anytime I make a video, I like to put my name across it. Because you wouldn't believe how many people will actually go out and steal your videos and post them up. I actually saw one of my videos posted up on someone else's channel using everything. The only thing they did was they muted out the sound of my voice and they muted out the clips, you know, audio, and then they just put music and they put their voice over it. So this is why I label my videos, so that no one can capture my videos without me receiving credit. And what I'm doing right here right now is this is a clip where I'm actually in the warship And I don't want you to sit here and watch me go through the warship for days. You know how slow that thing is. So what I'm doing is I'm actually speeding it up. Okay? I'm speeding it up so I can go through here and do it fairly quickly. So you can either speed a video up or you can slow it down. But you pick the segment that you're working in. You highlight it. Of course, it's highlighted in blue. And then you can go and manipulate it. Everything in PowerDirector 10, to my knowledge, you can manipulate in any fashion you want. And now what I want to do is, like you saw in the video, I put some writing across and it said, how do you do that? Well, I'm going to take one of my templates that I already have in PowerDirector 10. And I'm going to take that template and put it back down. I'm going to put it on the next adjacent video track. And I don't need this part down here, so I take that out. I'm only going to use one title, and then I'm going to change it to how he do that. And of course it's too big, so let's size it down, let's highlight it, you know, just like if you were working in Word or anything like that. Let's go highlight it, and let's go, no, that's too small, let's go a little bit bigger. That's about right. Now let's change the font, because I don't like this font, so I can change the font to whatever I have on my, I have Windows 7. And so whatever fonts that Windows 7 has, of course, you can use in PowerDirector 10, because that's where it's pulling those fonts from, okay? So if you have downloaded some extra funky fonts, you can, you know, integrate them into PowerDirector 10, because it's actually using the feed from there. And now I'm going to change it back to the color that I used in one of my videos when I said I was going to start this series, because I want you to see, you know, that there's some transition from here to there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually go back to that old video and probably put this video and kind of link it, so that if you click on that video and I put how do you do that, and I might put something around it, and then if you click there, then of course it'll jump you to this video. These are some of the things that you can do when you think about it, you know, and it will bring people to that series. And now basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to give this these words some animation. So we come into the animation side, and you have all these different type of animations. And what I know, that's no, that's not the right one. The one I like to use, like I did in a video, was called swarm. You can swarm from the left, or you can swarm from the right, and I think I want to go down here and swarm to my left. Yeah, that's it. Select that. That's for my intro. And then we can go down here and select the outro, how I want it to end. Let's just pick glow. That's quick and easy. So, you know, here we save it. And then let's go, of course, we got to review it. I'm extended a little bit out before the other part of transition. And let's go ahead and review it. Remember, always review your work. Again, don't rush through it. So we'll review everything from the beginning. Here it is. How do you do that? Back, 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 back. You know, and this is one of the things that I do all the time. So before I actually upload my videos, I review them over and over and over again. I know it's tedious. I know some of you have schedules and you don't have time to do all that, but I challenge you to do it. I challenge you to not just be cookie cutter, like I said. Be different. Be like me. Anyway, so this is how I did it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I froze a little bit right there, but I hope you enjoyed this video. And of course, if you have any more questions, if I didn't cover something, if I went too quickly, of course, go back, rewind this video, and view it again. But thank you for tuning in to my channel, and thank you for watching my videos. And I will continue this series on how to do that. I'll get more in depth, so don't worry if I didn't cover something today. I can't cover it all in one video. This video is already long enough. So peace. I'm Tag, and I'm out.